Good day, I'm Andrea Chisholm, and this is your GIS News for Wednesday, December 4. Government will begin preparing for the 2014-2015 financial year during a special cabinet meeting on Thursday and Friday of this week at Jamaica House. A release from the Office of the Prime Minister said the special cabinet meeting would review the country's medium-term economic program and the macroeconomic projections, the country's growth strategies and social protection programs, as well as progress made in priority programs and projects will also be discussed. Following those discussions, the government will outline its strategic priorities for the 2014-2015 financial year. Government has five strategic priorities for the current financial year: fiscal prudence and the pursuit of a credible economic program, job creation and economic growth, improved security and safety, human capital development, and effective social inclusion. The governments of Jamaica and Trinidad and Tobago have agreed to several actions to improve trade and travel relations between the two countries. It follows 2 days of bilateral consultations chaired by the foreign affairs ministers of both countries from December 2 to 3 in Jamaica.
I believe what we have achieved at the end is a very robust approach, consistent with the aspirations of community law that affects the movement of persons in the community.
After meetings with Jamaican private sector leaders, the ministers agreed to work together to find solutions to the issues affecting bilateral trade. As it regards the free movement of citizens between both countries, they agreed that immigration officials should operate within the context of the Shanique Myrie CCJ ruling and the limits imposed by community law. Immigration legislation and procedures in both countries should also be reviewed to ensure that CARICOM nationals' right of entry is respected and that an appeals process is in place for those denied entry.
Notwithstanding the fact that a significant number of Jamaicans have entered Trinidad and Tobago without any difficulty, and might I just pause, that's about 96%. We have agreed that the immigration authorities of both countries must cooperate in addressing allegations of profiling.
Regular cooperation and real-time information sharing between immigration authorities of Jamaica and Trinidad was also agreed to. And in that vein, Minister Ducaran has invited Minister Nicholson to hold a second round of consultations in Port of Spain in the first quarter of 2014 to take stock and follow up on the agreements reached in Kingston. Some good news now for the tourism sector. Portfolio Minister Dr. Wicker McNeil announced Tuesday that the industry has reversed losses suffered at the start of the year, with numbers now showing resurgence in arrivals and bookings.
The summer is up nearly 3% over last year, and the fall and winter are pacing well ahead of last year.
Dr. McNeil was speaking at a press launch of the 2014 Caribbean Travel Marketplace planned for January 12 to 14 at the Montego Bay Convention Center. Dr. McNeil said the outlook for the sector would become even more positive due to the ministry's robust marketing efforts. He added that the Caribbean Travel Marketplace should also bring together the world's biggest tour operators and help foster further growth.
Caribbean Marketplace 2014 promises to be one of the largest stages ever, having already attracted a significant number of buyer delegates so far.
More than 20,000 people have been added to the national voters list. The Electoral Office of Jamaica, EOJ, has published the November 30, 2013 voters list showing approximately 1.7 million registered electors. 6,974 names were removed from the list and 29,105 added. Director of Elections Orit Fisher says ID cards for those who have been added to the list will be ready for distribution by December 13. Copies of the list will be placed at post offices across the country and will also be available at the EOJ constituency offices. And finally, Prime Minister Portia Simpson-Miller has called for the full integration in society of persons with disabilities. Her comments came Tuesday as the country observed Disability Awareness Day under the theme "Break Barriers, Open Doors for an Inclusive Society for All." Mrs. Simpson-Miller said over the years, persons with disabilities had been marginalized and isolated, and this has kept them among the poorest in the world. She insisted that it was incumbent on all to eradicate the obstacles and create a more inclusive society for them. At the state level, the Prime Minister said her administration was determined to enact legislation to protect the rights of persons with disabilities. She assured that this would be done during the current legislative year. And that's it for GIS News today. I'm Andrea Chisholm. Thank you for watching.